Hello, me again. If you have crafting supplies everywhere like I do, I mean, you guys, you should see this table. It looks totally horrendous. And you've got sandpaper you need to keep. Here's a tip. Use a folder. It'll keep all those little pieces of sandpaper because sometimes you don't need a big sheet. You just need to cut a piece out for a small area. Keep all your sandpaper in a folder. It makes it a lot easier to store it. Plus, I hate the texture of the sandpaper. I'm big on texture, so I don't like running my hands down it when I'm looking for something, so this makes it easier. Hi, Cones. I'm gonna make a harvest wreath for a friend of mine who lives in Canada with these maple lights, and I found these pine cones. I got a lot of my supplies at the Dollar Tree, but these smell good. These are pine cones. These are scented. Oh, I love the smell. I think you use them in potpourri. These little containers you saw me with in the other video, which is uploading now, these are great for little things like this, like googly eyes and odds and ends. They're not just for ketchup and salad dressing. If you've got stencils or stickers, use a gallon-sized Ziploc. It'll help you keep your stencils and stuff in one contained space so that you don't lose them and they don't go everywhere. You can also get these. They're just plastic empty craft bottles that are great for storing things. Now, a tip, hold on, I gotta chase down the super glue. A tip for you if you use super glue of any kind, a friend of mine told me this. If you keep it in the refrigerator, it will hold its staying power longer. If you keep it cold in the refrigerator, it will work better for you. Can't get the bottle open. Also, if you have cling wrap and you want to be able to work with it a little better, keep the roll of cling wrap in the refrigerator. And you have a very short span of time, under 5 minutes, to work with it before it starts sticking to itself. But when it's cold, it doesn't stick to itself as much, so it makes it easier to work with. Now, I have tons of these little glues, so I put them in there, and then I stick this in the door of my refrigerator. It makes it so that when I open the fridge, they're not rolling everywhere, but they're cold, so they'll stay good longer. I rolled over my own trash bag, wouldn't you know? But just, you know, a few little tips. And you can get things, say you don't have a lot of money, but you want to do personalize a gift. I did this for my niece when she had both of her boys. I got two of these, well, one each. I painted it a color. I think green was one and blue was the other because green is the mom's favorite color. So, and then you get those stick-on letters, or you can use a stencil or freehand. Do the person's, the name right here. And then right here, you can do, like, if it's a little boy, puts a little toy train, glue it on there, or stencil something right there, or just do the name again. And this gives them a custom piece, and you're not spending a lot. So I have extra frames that I keep, and then all you gotta do is find a good picture and stick it in there. Someone lost their pet or something, put a picture of the pet in one of these, paint it up, and then put the picture of the pet in and gift it to them. It gives you a easy, quick gift that you're not gonna spend a lot on if you don't have a lot of money and you still wanna give something that has a bit of a personal touch to it. And these you can get, all this you can get at the Dollar Tree. Like I said before, and I'm sorry, I don't mean to preach, but don't spend a ton of money on your crafts. I'm gonna paint a series of these animals and sell them as a set for a child's bedroom. I'm going through the flowers and getting all the flowers in one place and then all the extra stuff in another. Because see, here's the thing, and it's okay to store these, but if you store them like this, you're gonna have a hard time because they're long, they are not flexible. And plus, I don't use these stems. If you still want a little bit of the stem, just cut it, like right here. Let me show you, I cut one I sometimes cut them. See, like this, it's got the berries and the leaf, but I didn't want this part. So I just cut it off. So it makes it easier to store. These fake Johnny Jump Ups here, I'm gonna just pop the heads right off and then put it in a tub with other flowers and greenery, and that's all that's going in this tub is flowers and greenery. So you can pull it when you want to make a wreath or whatever you're making, a bridal bouquet. Now, if you're making a bridal bouquet, you might want to keep some of the stems, but if you don't want a stem and this, and you don't have a big tub, again, go for your gallon Ziploc bags. Put all the greenery in one bag. Put all the roses in one bag. Put, you know, if you want to organize, and then put the stack the bags somewhere if you don't have a tub. Or if you have a tub, but you don't want them all jumbled like this, that's another way you can organize them by type or by color or by use even, whatever, you know, whatever your plan is. So, thought I'd give you that little tip. Because see, here's one that I've done that with. These are little miniature poinsettias. And I wanted to keep them in the flower bag, but I wanted to keep them together, especially since they're so small. So they're in a Ziploc bag, and then that just gets tossed into the bin. I also use things like this on the wreath. I will probably take the bell off of the bow and put it on something else. But for now, it's fine the way it is. So I keep that separate. Little plastic candies, whatever you want to put. Oops. This is another thing. You can get these at the Dollar Tree for your kids to paint. And you don't have to, if you don't have kids, you can still pick them up. And these, once these are empty, keep these little containers, wash them out, and it's a great way to travel with a project without having to travel with your whole project kit. And I'll paint anything, even if it doesn't sit still, I think. And see, I've got some of these. These are owls. And they're color your own ornaments. I'm going to take some of those googly eyes. I'm going to do a series of colors and then take the googly eyes, put the googly eyes on them, and then use Mark fine tip brush and put in the leaves and stuff. And then I'll sell them. Or I may just put my nephew's names and you know, family members' names on it, and then hang them on the tree for a unique family ornament. And that does not go in the floral tub. See, I get to talking to you all and forget what I'm doing. But see, you just snug this into a little bit of flowers when you're making the wreath or whatever, and it looks really pretty. You've got some here that's got white on it. I think that's really gorgeous. And it works really good, but you still have to store all this. Here, let me show you the difference. This is the after tub. Okay? This is before. See how much more difficult this is because it's all spiny and stuck up? But you do you. You know, if you like the spiny and stuck up things, that's fine. I don't. Drives me absolutely buggy. And the flower tub that I'm taking it out of will become the these types of things that will go on the wreaths. I might use those owls, paint them for, like, say, a family member that's got kids, and then put them on a wreath, each individual name on the wreath, on the owl. That would be pretty, I think. That would make a cute gift. Or like, if you're a lot more handy, you could find a longer piece. You can get those at the Dollar Tree too. There are signs already painted. Just paint over that or flip them over and then put like the family name, like say the Smith family. And then take the little owl ornaments and put them on the wreath too with each member's name on it for the front door. Ideas abound. You just got to be a little open-minded. Never be afraid to use your imagination, no matter what your age. Look at those. Aren't they pretty? I love real plants, but with these, you don't gotta water them and they're not gonna die on you. I won't say they don't create a mess because you can create a mess with these too. If you're hearing crunching, that's my boy. He's crunching on a bone that I got him. Sorry, I dropped my trash bag. If you look back a few videos, I got him a gigantic bone. Laughingly, I like to call it his dinosaur bone, and he's still working on that. Here's another kind of wreath form. They're not all circles. This one's a little star. Isn't that adorable? That will look so cute lit up for Christmas with a few different decorations on it. And you don't always have to put the decorations here. Let me find one. I'll use the owls, but you know, just pretend this is something bright and shiny. You could put it behind it. Like that, like a dove or something inside the star. I had doves. I don't know where I put them. I never know where I put things when I'm sorting. And see, here's the another type of light. You can barely see them. These are fairy lights. They're so tiny. These are called rice lights, because, and that's probably what will go on the star, are these rice lights. And the battery pack, or you can do the star out and put the battery pack behind the star in the center here so that it's hidden when you light it up. And that's probably what will happen on this one. That's a way to hide the battery pack. You know, and or here's like I was saying, if you didn't want to hide the battery pack, you could do something like that. And then just put lights on it. Something if you want real minimalistic. Depends on what you want to do, you know? There's always craft ideas and options out there. Should have known a star wouldn't fit in a round hole. Square peg, round hole. Oh, these are really good too. The decorative bell ornaments, they're great for crafting with wreaths or whatever. But again, you gotta have to find a place to store them if you don't want to store them in the package, which I don't like to do because when I'm crafting, I don't want to have to stop and open something. I want to have it already done, already opened, so I can just keep chugging along and having fun. And this one's a string of them. And so I'll just put it, if I can ever get the package open. By the way, if you can hear the music in the background, which I don't know if you can or not, it's not mine. I don't own the rights. But there, now it's all in one place, combined, and I can still find it when I want it. Got some little gold flowers. Dropped some greenery. I know someone who can pick things up with his toes, and he's so good with his toes, he can actually pinch people with his toes. I am not that dexterous. Oh, here's, my mom picks some of this stuff up, and she just brings it home. Candy cane. And so I just store some of it sometimes, and I never know what I've got because I haven't gone through it in a while. Another candy cane or star. With, when you have two wreath forms that are both wire, and they're the same type, and if you really want to do it, line them up and use a zip tie to secure them, and then put them together, and you can still put your battery packs on the inside if you want to. But if I, you know, I've done it to where I've only zip tied one side, so it kind of hinged open like that. And then you put just like a tie here so they can tie it shut. That way they can access the battery pack, but they have a double-sided star. Just another idea. I love different things. Even these little bitty flowers can work to be a little bit of pop of when you don't want something great big, you know, great big swatch of color or whatever. If you want, if you're doing a piece that's real dainty, these great, these little flowers are great for that. I don't usually do live streams, so that's why I just did another video with you guys while I was doing this, because I can't see the chat, so I wouldn't be able to respond real well. Plus, I'm on my phone, so I don't really do lives, but I don't know how many of you do wreaths and stuff or even interested in this stuff, but I am. I enjoy it. And there's times when you've got to take time for yourself. You have to do something for you, because if you don't take care of yourself, how are you going to take care of anybody else? And sometimes that means getting away, doing some crafts, painting a rock, screaming and dancing in the shower, whatever is you. Sometimes it's very therapeutic when I'm angry to tear apart some flowers. You don't want to take your anger out on other people, so you can do it that way. Now see, I'm not going to take this one apart, because I think it would work just the way it is. Isn't that kind of pretty? I think that's pretty. You can also take these little, I know you've seen these everywhere. You can paint these and maybe put a little fake birdie in there, or, you know, some really little green, little bitty flower or something in there, and then hang it up. Or you can even make this into a Christmas ornament. I've seen these on trees of people who love birdhouses. You know, they just hot glued a pipe cleaner as the hanger. What am I doing? See, I got you talking again. I've got these. I don't exactly know what I'm going to do with them, but I think they're kind of pretty. Here's a set of battery-operated lights I like to use for spring and summer wreaths, because they're little flowers. And when you find those types of things, grab them, even if you're not planning on using them right away, because you're going to want to stock up. But you don't need to take your whole house, because not everybody has storage space. I live in a one-bedroom senior apartment, and, you know, things get shoved wherever you can shove them. These are erasers. But when I make my Easter wreath, these are so cute, nestled in the greenery. So even if it's not technically a craft item, you can turn it into one. There's uses for everything, even erasers, in the crafting world. And they're so little. You can do an Easter wreath with Easter eggs and plant and put the little bunnies around. It's cute. But that's what I've been doing. And I wanted to tell you guys how to store your sandpaper, because I had forgotten to mention it until I found mine. These are good buried in a wreath too. If someone likes bells, get the little ones. And they're smaller ones than this. You could make a whole wreath. One of these, especially one this size. Let me give you the size on this one. This decoration is for indoor use only. Oh, kidding. They must think we're idiots. I don't have a size on this one, but you could do it all the way around with just little bells. The whole thing could be a bell wreath. Not done with that yet. Now, if you have pieces like this that come off of something else, this is just, keep those, because you can actually use this to tie something onto the wreath, and it won't, if you do it with something that like a poinsettia that's edged in gold and you need to tie down one, or you just want to make sure it stays, use that. But again, it's really small, so I don't want to lose it. So I'm going to put it in one of these jars. Because sometimes you want to keep your wreath former, you can reuse it, and you don't want hot glue all over if you want to reuse the wreath form. It's okay to have a craft, just save money doing it. I'm just going to pick all that up later. Yeah, see, I've got several of these I'm not even going to take apart. They're doing it for me. There's some that I am, like this. Now, this is a bigger piece that I'm not going to take apart, but I like the look. In a really, really big wreath, you could work this in. You still have to cut it down a little bit, but you could still work this in, or flower arrangements. This would look good in the center. These are really pretty, aren't they? I love color. I love all different kinds of color. Now, I did change my mind on this one. I am going to take it apart a little bit to show you how to take apart something like that. These are just pulling the heads off. And see, if it comes off like that, that's fine. You can use that too. They don't have to all come off up here at the base. You can keep them a little longer for a little bit of a change the look. Some of the flowers you're gonna want close to the wreath form, and there's others that you want a little farther away from the wreath form. You wanna give your wreath a look of depth. So it's good to have some of the stems and stuff sometimes. So you have different heights. It's like when you're doing a centerpiece at the table. You wanna make sure it's a cute centerpiece and all, but you don't wanna have a centerpiece so tall that you can't see your company over the centerpiece. It's the same thing, except you want the wreath to be able to it look good from close up or far away. Giving the wreath a little more depth will do that. It will give you the, it's an illusion. It's an optical illusion. Sorry about that. I couldn't stand leaving it on the floor. Now, when you want to take apart something that's taller like this, you're still going to be able to take it apart. Number one, this one's got floral tape on it. So the first thing I'm going to do is remove the floral tape because the floral tape's holding it close, holding it tight. And I don't want that. I want that off. I'm going to hate myself when I have to go clean this up. And as you take off the floral tape, you'll notice the green long stems are coming off in a piece because they're just wrapped on there. They're wrapped around the base. See what that is? You can use that. Just keep, if you want to use it like this and you don't want to cut them off here, if you want to keep them all together, put a piece of tape right there. Piece of clear scotch tape. And then you got this you can work with. Tape will hold it closed. Now look, see how that sat on those? You're going to pull that off. Separate it out to the side so you can hold one at a time, and it just slides right off. Yeah, sure it does. There's the flower, and the grass will just slide right off. And if you're worried about it coming apart, like that one I showed you, just put a little bit of floral tape or scotch tape on the bottom of it. It'll be hidden by your wreath, so you're not gonna have to worry about it, but it does keep it together. When I'm taking apart a flower, I grab right where it connects to the, now see, that's what happens if you don't grab right where it connects to the stalk. You'll grab the head of this is a butterfly. You'll pull them off, which is fine for the butterfly. It didn't need to be on the body, but that's why you grab the flowers under the petals at the base, like this. And then pull it off so you're not pulling it apart. Some of the flowers are not all, it looks like all one flower, but it might be two or three parts. And if that happens, don't fret, don't panic, because it will happen. Sometimes things are going to fall apart on you. Grab some floral tape, scotch tape, super glue. There's a myriad of different ways to fix a foul up. And if you have to toss it, if the flower just got ruined beyond all hope, if you're getting them at the Dollar Tree, you don't have to worry about it. That's why I always grab a few extra. If I'm in there to only buy one, I buy two. That way, if it messes up, then, you know, if I have to toss it because I couldn't get it apart and I needed to see how it was put together before I can pull it apart, I've got a second one that I can still use once I understand how to get it apart. Does that make sense? See, these are got a bit of a problem because this is in my way. This is what the flower was being held onto the stem with. And if I can get, see where it holds right there, pull. That's all there is to it. Now that I pulled that off, that slides right off. I want these because sometimes I'm gonna want a little bit of a longer look. And what you can do if it's broken near the top right here, take your pair of scissors and cut them kind of at an angle. Cause see, some of the tips are naturally at an angle if you look at your plants that you're growing. So just, you know, clip, 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 give it a little haircut to the height that you want. No big deal. This is, we are not Pablo Picasso. We are just having fun. But that's how you tear that apart. And then you toss it in the floor so it can bug you later. I'm, I guess, neurotic. And you got all different kinds of leaves. Some of them are small, some of them are, you know, just like on a real plant. And these butterflies are so adorable and will be really fun to put on a spring or summer wreath. Have it hovering around a flower. Maybe add a rice light, one of the little ones I showed you, or a small or a little bit bigger fairy light underneath it so it glows. Wouldn't a child love that? All right, these are Christmas ornaments. This is, of course, the dove. There's others on this table somewhere. If I showed you the table, you'd understand why I said somewhere. But I put these on wreaths too, because it gives a little color. And you get five, I think, in here. Yeah, there's five in this pack for a dollar. And you wouldn't use all five unless it was... Now, if it's a larger wreath, then, yeah, you might use all five. If it's like 26 inches or above, then I would use all five. Because you want it... But if it's a littler wreath, like what I've got here, you might use one or two. Because you could even use it in the center, just dangle it from a piece of gold wire or something like that. Now, again, these are the rice lights. You can find these on online. I get them everywhere. I get them from Wish.com. I get them from Amazon. I get them from everywhere. I get them from the Dollar Tree. If I find them, though, I don't just buy one pack that I need for a project. I'll buy six or seven because I know I'll need them later, and they don't always sell them. But at certain times of the year, like now, they put out the Halloween ones. So when I went to Dollar Tree the other day, when I showed you that haul, I got as many as I could afford to get because I wanted to be able to have them for future projects. And since I'm not doing the craft fair this year, I was going to put some things on Facebook Marketplace to sell. Now, see, this is the small little rose. You might use that in the birdhouse. In fact, let's see how that would look. Now, you'd probably take it off the stem and glue it into the opening. How you do that is you put glue on the rim of the opening, and then you just insert your flower like that and glue it right there. Or you can put the whole stem in like I just did and just, you don't have to glue it, but I would glue it. But then, and maybe put something right there. A little bird, a little eraser that's a birdie. Put him coming out on the perch and put the flower under here. there's no limit, and there's no reason not to use your imagination, no matter how old you are. Here, I'll show you what's bugging me. Look at this. I hate having all this stuff on my floor. As you can see, my floor is dirty anyway, because I didn't sweep this morning. I usually sweep several times a day, but... And then, see, you've got all kinds of sizes and options for that. Yeah. I was going to show you what a different size would look like, but I don't know where I put the birdhouse. Sometimes you'll get more than one wreath form for these. This was two for a dollar. Now, if you want to, you can take a pair of tin snips and snip these parts right here, and then you can come away with at least two. This one can be one wreath form. This one could be, these two could be a different size. Or you could make just three different wreath forms out, just pulling these, snipping these off. So you don't have to keep them in the triple shape you got here. You can always take them apart. And if you're a kid, let your parents handle the sharp stuff, please. Again, you can cannibalize other Christmas ornaments and stuff that has seen its better days and change it into something else. That would look cute in a wreath. In fact, design the wreath around, hold on, there we go, and then when they open the door, it dingles. Now sometimes you really want to keep these too, these little berries, put it with a little bit of greenery of any type. And it doesn't have to be the greenery that came with it. And then you've got something else you can use. One of these tubs will fill up pretty fast when you're taking flowers apart. But don't worry about that. They'll all fit in one tub. If they get a little smooshed when you're working with them, just re-fluff the petals a little bit and it'll be just fine. You don't have to make sure they don't get smooshed. They're going to get smooshed. It's like my stepfather used to hate it when my bread got smooshed. Well, you're going to eat it anyway. You eat it, smoosh it when you eat it, don't you? It never made sense to me to be picky about that. But hey. And you can use these words. Just paint them up. Peace is my favorite word, so I painted up one that said peace. Just paint this up, maybe add a little bit of greenery down here or some flowers, or get some of those character erasers like the bunnies and put them right through here with a little greenery. This tub is turned into a bit of a mixed bag. Here's another thing that you can use for your green, especially, this works really good, especially with evergreen wreaths, because the color is harder to distinguish on an evergreen wreath. If you're tying things onto it instead of using glue and the wreath is already evergreen, it's going to be harder to see this, and you can just see your decorations and not how you affixed them to the wreath. Goes on the table. Now here's another summer or spring. You could use these lights for summer or spring, or making a wreath for a little child for their birthday with their name on it or something, and say they like butterflies that they can hang in their bedroom. A lot of little kids like nightlights. That would be a neat little nightlight. They could help you make their own nightlight, a craft project while everybody's still at home. Because I don't know about where you live, but they're putting the mask mandates back in place here in St. Clair. I have a feeling they're going to lock us down again. Don't quote me on that. That's just, I pretty much quarantine myself because I don't want to get this. So I stay away from people, and I've been doing a lot of crafts and stuff like that. Or I plan to. These are distinctly Christmas, but if you didn't want, you can take this and these apart. Here, just move them away like that and snip with a pair of scissors. Then you would be left with just the pine cone for an autumn leaf or the beginning of winter. Another thing you can do with pine cones. Yep, these are scented too. I love them. But go outside with your kids when the pine cones are on the ground and pick up a big open one like this or buy it. Fill it with peanut butter inside the little pine cone openings. Put peanut butter all on it and then roll it in bird seed. Take a twist tie or something and or string, tie it up in a tree as a natural bird feeder. There's a whole bunch of projects you can do with your kids year round. And see, even the little flowers come apart. Because sometimes you don't want something real big. So you take apart some of the small stuff. Actually, I am going to put pine cones in the flowers. Like I said, if your flowers get smooshed, you can re-fluff them. I don't know why they have these scented, but I love the smell. Here's another way to do it. This is a flexible tie. You might have to get some of this stuff in a garden section or something. It's good to get it while it's available in the summer and then hold on to it. Because, like I said, with an evergreen wreath, using green ties would be easier if you don't want to use super glue. And sometimes super glue won't work on some decorations, so you need to find an alternate way to secure them to the wreath. Boy, do I have enough pine cones, folks? Don't know where those scented pine cones came from, but I want more of them. I like them. See? Floral tape. This is useful stuff, and you'll go through quite a bit of it, but if you can get it at Walmart, Dollar Tree, Garden Center. So here's another of the flexible ties. Now some of that my mom came in with to ask me, can you use this? She won't know if I can use it or not. She'll just buy it and give it to me and find a use for this, you know. That's how I started doing the wreaths. She bought the wreath forms and she's like, here, I want you to make me some wreaths. You know, and that's how I got started painting ceramics. My grandparents had passed and mom and I were living at their house. And mom said, you know, said we need to do something with those ceramics. They're looking awful old. And then she looks at me because I had just started with the art group. I hadn't been painting very long. Few weeks, maybe a month. And mom goes, can you paint those? I don't know, mom. Well, would you ask down there at the art group and see if they know how to help you paint them? And I took the picture because the one she wanted me to start with was really big. And they helped me figure out. I started with outside house paint that the ladies had left from when they redid the outside of their houses. And instead of throwing that away, they gave it to me so I could use it on the statues. And from there I branched out, and the first couple ceramics, they looked okay, but nothing to write home about. You know, I think I'm much better now, which expect that. You know, after you start doing it something new, once you get the hang of it, you're gonna look back at your first attempts and go, oh my Lord, but it's worth it if you put your mind to doing something. And if you're in quarantine or someone you know is in quarantine and you want these flowers done up and they, you know, it, like say you've got a kid at home you have to quarantine, or they've got mumps or measles or they're sick and they you want to keep their hands busy so they don't scratch, make them do this. Just be careful, they might scratch using the stems to scratch their back. I would've. That's how I know. I was a little bit of a stinker as a kid. Got in trouble at Shriners one time for accidentally running into the doctor cast first. We were racing down the hall. Me and several of my friends were racing side by side, the wheelchairs down the hallway. And I turned the corner and I didn't know that my doctor was coming around the corner and I ran into him with both legs in a cast. So he was in a little bit of discomfort. I was only 5. Then they decided to put us in bed, but their problem with that was we were all in the same room. I got mad at the nurse for making me go to bed, so a little stinker that I was, I stole her stethoscope. And we played keep away with it. They waited till my grandpa got there and then they told on me. Then I got in trouble. But hey, I was 5 years old. What are you gonna do, right? See, they come apart so easy. And you don't have to keep all of it if you don't want it. If you only want one or two pieces and you don't have room to store the rest of it, throw it away. You can always get another dollar. Look in the couch cushions. I'm sure you can find a dollar in your couch cushions. Now, you do have little bitty things. I'm talking little. Definitely put those in a container. Because you're not going to be able to find them if you don't. And there are places when you want something that small. Never throw anything away just because it's not apparent what the use is right then. If you can find a way to store it, that is. For your crafts, I mean. If you never threw anything away, then we'd all be in trouble, right? Crosses. Now I have an idea with these. I just haven't got there yet. I've got another one that has a cutout in the center and I'm going to put them back to back with white lights on the edges so that when you plug it in it'll shine through the other first cross. And there's two hearts that I'm going to do the same way. Think I got enough wreath forms, folks? Ah! Now these... The box is tearing up anyway. See these? These are another battery operated light that you can get. These are leaves. I think I've only got one of those. So you really can do a wreath for just about anything. It's just what can you imagine? What can you dream? If you can dream it, you can do it, no matter what it is. Because if they said that just because you dream something doesn't mean you could do it, then Orville and Wilbur Wright never would have flown. A man would have never walked on the moon. Everything started as somebody's dream. I want to open a tutoring center, and I get so discouraged some days, and I think, well, what makes me think I can do this and be a success? Who am I to think that I'm just a background person in life. I'm a choir singer, not a soloist. And then a friend of mine, Connie Ann, she was like, well, sure, if you think that way, if you think you can or think you can't, you're absolutely right. It's not what other people think of you that matters. If you have a dream, that dream is there. Because you can accomplish it. My cousin plays, I don't exactly know how many instruments, but he has a dream. And he was not a good student. More googly eyes. He was not a great student in school. He's not a brilliant mind. I love him, but he's not. Got ADD and he's scattered sometimes. That's no problem. I'm not saying it's a bad thing that he has ADD. What I'm saying is he has a dream. He has a dream that he's told me about. He wants to open a business and he's told me all about it and it's perfect for him. I'm not going to say what because I don't have clearance to say what. I didn't ask him if I could say what. But he has a dream that is so perfect for who he is and what he loves to do. I know he can do it. It doesn't matter what your shortcomings are. Maybe you're a germaphobe, a neat freak, or a slob. Maybe you're a hoarder. Those are just words. They only have power. I'm crippled. And for a long time, that word had power over me. I have cerebral palsy. I have cerebral palsy. Cerebral palsy doesn't own me. It doesn't have me. I no longer let it control my life. You get static cling, lick or wet your fingers. It'll help with static cling when you're picking things up. But I used to let that word rule me. I used to tell people that I was broken. Not only in my body, but I think differently than others. And so I always thought I was broken. I'm not broken. God doesn't break things. He puts them back together. Am I disabled? Depends. You thought I was going to say yes or no. It depends on how you define it. Do I lack the ability that some people possess to do certain things? Then yes, I'm disabled. But does that make me inable? No. I don't drive a car like you, but I drive. I drive a mobility scooter. I saw one the other day. It's enclosed. It looks like a little car, but it's a mobility scooter. I want it so bad. Sorry, off topic. See, there's that too. Does that make me broken because I swing off topics and I go down rabbit trails and my brain gets all scattered? No. Doesn't make me broken. Kids, if you're listening to this and you've got, somebody's told you you've got this or you've got that, don't let that this or that, like ADD, HD, or autism, don't let that define you. You draw your own picture. I am who I create. God gave me great raw material. Man caused problems. It was man who caused my early birth. It was man's difficulties that caused me to become disabled. And it's man that labels me. And it was me that labeled me. Don't label yourself. Okay, serious topic over for the moment. Oh, come on. We've been talking this long and you didn't think I was going to do something like that? Please. Then you don't know me very well. All right. Valentine's Day comes around. You want something to hang up for Valentine's Day. You take this. You paint this like a deep red. Paint this a lighter red or even red and pink. And then in here on the border, like right like this, you put those little red lights. Maybe put a hole through here so you could put the lights, pull them through, and then wind them. And then you glue the battery pack over the hole back here. And then you have this double heart. You could even offset it like that, like that, like that. That would light up. That's my plan. Now the question is, where do I get a drill? I think I'm gonna have to go to Mom's. Ah, here's the other part of the cross. So that's the idea. With the lights behind it. But again, I gotta borrow a drill, so I think I'm gonna have to ask Mom for help. Because I don't own one. Not that I don't know how to use one. I've seen them used plenty. I can figure that out. But I don't own one. She does. Sometimes something gets broken. Something you want to keep gets broke like this. Does this mean I can't use it in this form? Yeah. Take it apart. You can take these parts off and then stick them for 3D effect and onto something. Like that. Just take off the broken part. That's all. Or throw it away. Don't matter to me none. Now I'll show you some more lights. I love lights. Oh, yeah. See, you can get the words Merry Christmas. They had these red, silver, and gold. By the time I got there to get another set, they only had the red left. So you can use all kinds of stuff like that. Here's another light set whose box has seen better days. And again, I use these on a spring wreath. The little dragonflies. Now, don't expect $100 quality out of this stuff, okay? For what it is, it's good. Really. But it's not going to be $100 quality good. Of course, who has $100 to blow on crafting supplies? Well, just one, I mean. And don't be afraid of color. Don't be, if you want something that's monocolor, fine. But if you want a little bit of color in a, say you're doing a mainly white wreath, it would be pretty to add a little bit of cream, a cream flower in with the white. See how this has the gold and everything on the inside? So you mimic that on a white wreath. You do all whites and then you add a little gold, add a little cream. That mimics what's already there. It will enhance the single color while not distracting from it. If you want to do something in that manner, like for a wedding. Just, it's going on the color wheel. Your shape, sorry guys. That hit you. Your shading is what you're doing. Going on the color wheel and doing a variant of the white. Just use other colors of white, just like creams, off-white, antique white, parchment are all great colors to add if you're doing a single white thing or pink. You know, use shades of that color. That way you're still got your single color, but it's not going to be blaring at you, oh my god, it's all white. You know, it'll have a depth, a shadow effect to it that will be able to balance out the single color that you're using and still look really good. You should see my floor. But I'll show you what I've done, how it looks. Sorry about the finger and the hand in the camera. Apologize, but I don't do editing. But see how that, but it will smoosh down. That's fine. And this will be one of the lightest tubs. Now, I purposely left a bell in there so I can hear it. I do better with what I hear. So I can hear when if I knock it down or something and I hear jingle, jingle, plop, I know the flowers fell. It's just one of the things I like to do. I go do the world a lot by sound. I can see. I just depend on my ears more than... See? Isn't that pretty? See how they built that in? You could use a lighter color green if you want. Just add this kind of leaf. Just pick a different greenery. If you want to do that. It is not... There is no in this world you're creating. There is only what do I want. You are the creator of whatever it is you're making. It is your dream, your world, your reality, your vision. If somebody wants to buy it and they see your vision, great. If they don't see your vision, then it wasn't meant for them. It was meant for someone else. That's how I look at it. You know, I'm not going to get upset just because someone didn't like my work enough. They didn't want to buy it. Boo-hoo, that's fine. It wasn't meant for you then. But if they buy it, they can see your vision in it. Of it. Does that make sense or does that sound hokey? Well, that's what I believe. I believe we all think differently. We have different visions of what is beautiful. Beauty is so different what's the old saying? Beauty's in the eye of the beholder. You're the beholder on this. This is your eye, your brain, your time. If you have kids and you do crafts with them, don't tell them, oh, you can't make that elephant purple with green spots. That's their elephant. If they want it purple with the green spots in their world, that's fine. There are times in this world where you can't use your imagination. You gotta buckle down with real life. That's fine too. But there's also times when if you don't let your imagination fly and you don't learn to when to play pretend or just let yourself relax and have fun, you're gonna bottle everything up, and that's how you have a nervous breakdown. I know, I did it. I used to bottle everything up. And I never would relax and use my imagination. And this would have been something that would have never, I would have never thought of. And I had a complete nervous breakdown. 97, 98. There's at least 6 months, I don't even remember. I wound up in the stress unit. Not fun. But I learned from it. I learned there's got to be time when you take time for your you time. You let your imagination have fun no matter what your age. Some people like to golf. Some people like to play paintball. Some people like to play video games. Some people like to craft. Let it out. Relax. And then you can go back to the grindstone without all the pressure. On that note, my table's a mess. My tub is full. And I'm going to go make a wreath. Have a good day.